Hi everyone and welcome back to one of our videos. Today I would like to talk about position verifications. I have received this brochure from UKIM on recommendations on uses of ECDIS in preventing incidents. And one of the topics is position verification. And I would like to show you some of the things you can use our Homo FMV ECDIS to do that. Some of you may have noticed that we've not been here for some while, but we have used the time when we have been gone to develop new short courses, online short courses in route planning, in chart management, in sensor management, alert management, and so on. Why should you take one of these courses? I would say if you want to become a little bit better in using the ECDIS, or you want to brush up that maybe you have not been working with route planning for a long time or chart management for a long time, and you just want to brush up on this topic, then these courses are perfect for you. Where do we find them? You find it on our website under NowSkills Online Training. And our website is www.furumotraining.com. So let's continue to this topic I want to talk to you about today on our ECDIS. So, position verification on the Furuno FMD ECDIS consists of one of the topics they mention in here is, amongst others, radar overlay. And the radar overlay can be turned on in the Overlay Now tools box on the page Echo, and just turn it on and then you will see the radar overlay. Then you can compare it to the chart and see if it fits. Don't mind my radar overlay because mine is a simulated one, but on your radar, or on your ECDIS, sorry, it looks a little bit better. Another one is if you use parallel indexing on your radar. That is another way to verify that your position is where it's supposed to be. The last thing you can use the ECDIS for is transferring a bearing and a distance to your ECDIS, either taken on a radar or in on your bearing diopter. So, let's show, we have just taken a bearing and a distance here on my radar. And, oh, you can see it's a little bit, let's just retake it here. Yeah, of course, moving. So, then I go to the lock button here. And let me see here, lock, and we have the event lock, and then the position event. And then we have the line of position, that's the one we're using. And when you are sailing, doing a speed through water, you have to use the continuous transfer. And our bearing was 309.2.2. Okay. But first you go here and find the point you are taking bearing off. And then you click on it. Then you correct it a little bit, it was 309. Like that. I can see it's the wrong thing I'm taking bearing off. Let's just change it to the right point. Yeah, that's what I see. Here. There we go. Oh, there it is. Okay. Good. Then you change the bearing to what it needed, and of course I took a distance also, so true bearing distance. Yes. 2.2, yeah, something like that. And then when you change like that, then you press add. Okay. Now you see you got a full square here, and then you already have an estimated position. Okay, so this is this is how you could do it. If you need a more accurate, of course you need two bearings and distances, or three bearing or three distances, to get a more accurate one. You might also want to take the radar overlay a little if it's a little bit obscuring your picture, maybe just switch it off and then do it. So this is how you could do precision verification on your ECDIS. So if you have any more questions or any questions to the uses of your ECDIS or your Furuno radar, please just write to me on YouTube, Facebook, and let us see what the future brings. Thank you so much for watching our videos and writing to us. I really love it. So keep on doing that and see you next time in another video.